नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। इल्यूमिनेटिंग टेक्स्ट 24 एंड टेक्स्ट 25 ऑफ चैप्टर 1, द फर्स्ट स्टेप इन गॉड रियलाइजेशन और सेकंड कैंटो द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। टेक्स्ट 24, विशेष तस्य देहो अयम स्थ विष्ठ शच स्थ वियसाम यत्रेदम व्यज्यते विश्वम भूतम भव्यम भवच्च सत। The gigantic manifestation of the phenomenal material world as a whole in the personal body of the absolute truth, wherein the universal resultant past, present and future of material time is experienced. Anything either material or spiritual is but an expansion of the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and as stated in the Bhagavad Gita 13.13, the omnipotent Lord has his transcendental eyes, heads and other bodily parts distributed everywhere. He can see, hear, touch or manifest himself anywhere and everywhere, for he is present everywhere as the super soul of all infinitesimal souls, although he has his particular abode in the absolute world. The relative world is also his phenomenal representation, because it is nothing but an expansion of his transcendental energy. Although if he is in his abode, his energy is distributed everywhere, just as the sun is localized as well as expanded everywhere, since the rays of the sun, being non-different from the sun, are accepted as expansions of the sun disk. In the Vishnu Puran 1.22.52, it is said that as fire expands its rays and heat from one place, similarly the Supreme Spirit, the Personality of Godhead, expands himself by his manifold energy everywhere and anywhere. The phenomenal manifestation of the gigantic universe is only a part of his Virata body. Less intelligent men cannot conceive of the transcendental all-spiritual form of the Lord, but they are astounded by his different energies, just as the aborigines are struck with wonder by the manifestation of lightning, a gigantic mountain or a hugely expanded banyan tree. The aborigines praise the strength of the tiger and the elephant because of their superior energy and strength. The asuras cannot recognize the existence of the Lord, although there are vivid descriptions of the Lord in the revealed scriptures. Although the Lord incarnates and exhibits his common strength and energy, and although he is accepted as the Supreme Personality of Godhead by learned scholars and saints like Vyas Dev, Narad, Asita and Devala in the past, and by Arjun in the Bhagavad Gita, as also by the Acharyas like Shankara, Ramanuja, Madhva and Lord Sri Chaitanya in the modern age. The Asuras do not accept any evidential proof from the revealed scriptures, nor do they recognize the authority of the great Acharyas. They want to see with their own eyes at once. Therefore, they can see the gigantic body of the Lord as Virat, which will answer their challenge. And since they are accustomed to paying homage to superior material strength like that of the tiger, elephant and lightning, they can offer respect to the Virata Roop. Lord Krishna, by the request of Arjun, exhibited his Virata Roop for the Asuras. A pure devotee of the Lord, being unaccustomed to looking into such a mundane gigantic form of the Lord, requires special vision for the purpose. The Lord therefore favored Arjun with special vision for looking into his Virata Roop, which is described in the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. This Virata Roop of the Lord was especially manifested not for the benefit of Arjun, but for that unintelligent class of men who accept anyone and everyone as an incarnation of the Lord and so mislead the general mass of people. For them, the indication is that one should ask the chief incarnation to exhibit his Virata Roop and thus be established as an incarnation. The Virata Roop manifestation of the Lord is simultaneously a challenge to the atheist and a favor for the Asuras, who can think of the Lord as Virat and thus gradually cleanse the dirty things from their hearts in order to become qualified to actually see the transcendental form of the Lord in the near future. This is the favor of the all merciful Lord to the atheists and the gross materialists. Text 25. Andakoshe sharire asmi sapta varna samayute vairajah purusho yo asau Bhagwan Dharana Shrayah. The gigantic universal form of the Personality of Godhead within the body of the universal shell, which is covered by sevenfold material elements, is the subject for the Virata conception. Simultaneously, the Lord has multifarious other forms, and all of them are identical with the original fountainhead form of the Lord Shri Krishna. In the Bhagavad Gita, it has been proven that the original transcendental and eternal form of the Lord is Shri Krishna, the absolute Personality of Godhead, but by his inconceivable potency Atma Maya, he can expand himself by multifarious forms and incarnations simultaneously without being diminished in his full potency. He is complete and although innumerable, complete forms emanate from him, he is still complete without any loss. That is his spiritual or internal potency. In the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, the personality of Godhead Lord Krishna manifested his Virata Roop just to convince the less intelligent class of men who cannot conceive of the transcendental form of the Lord as appearing just like a human being, that he factually has the potency of his claim to be the supreme absolute person without any rival or superior. Materialistic men can think, although very imperfectly, of the huge universal space comprehending an innumerable number of planets as big as the sun. They can see only the circular sky overhead without any information that this universe, as well as many other hundreds of thousands of universes, are each covered by sevenfold material coverings of water, fire, air, sky, ego, noumenon and material nature, just like a football pumped and covered, floating on the water of the causal ocean, wherein the Lord is lying as Mahavishnu. All the universes in seed are emanating from the breathing of the Mahavishnu, who is but a part of partial expansion of the Lord, and all the universes presided over by the Brahmas vanished when the Mahavishnu withdraws his great breath. In this way, the material worlds are being created and vanished by the supreme will of the Lord. The poor foolish materialists can just imagine, who ignorantly put forwards an insignificant creature to become his rival incarnation simply on the allegations of a dying man. The Virata Roop was particularly exhibited by the Lord just to give lessons to such foolish men, so that one can accept a person as an incarnation of Godhead only if such a person is able to exhibit such a Virata Roop as Lord Krishna did. The materialistic person may concentrate his mind upon the Virat or gigantic form of the Lord in his own interest, and as recommended by Shukdev Goswami, but he must be on his guard not to be misled by pretenders who claim to be identical person as Lord Krishna but are not able to act like him or exhibit the Virata Roop comprehending the whole of the universe. Hare Krishna.